Good morning and welcome to our service on this All Saints Sunday. Throughout the year, on different days, we commemorate various saints, some on the date of their birth or the date of their death or at a key moment in their lives. But today on All Saints Sunday, it's an opportunity for us to give thanks to God for the whole communion of saints, all the saints who have been people who've worshipped God and tried to follow the example and teaching of Jesus Christ in their lives in all sorts of various ways. Some of those saints will be very famous and well known to us. Others will be known only to God. And the thing about the saints are that they're not people that are so sort of high and holy that we can't sort of attain to them, but they're cheering us on, encouraging us in our faith as well. And of course, as we worship God today in our service, we are reminded that also one of the things about the saints is that they are involved in the constant praise and worship of God in heaven. So as we come together for this service today, we pray that they would join in with our service and their prayers would be united with ours in glorifying God today. We meet in the name of God, God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit, God is one. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
As we think back over the last week, we bring before God those things which we have said and done, which we regret. And those things we have not done or said, which we wish we had. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May God our Father forgive you your sins and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. God of holiness, your glory is proclaimed in every age. As we rejoice in the faith of your saints, inspire us to follow their example with boldness and joy, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We're going to listen to our first reading, read for us by Matty, and then we'll stand as we hear the gospel reading read for us by Darcy.
The first reading comes from Revelation chapter 7. After this, I looked, and there were a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes, and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, saying, "Amen. Blessing to our glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white with the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them for any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe every tear away from their eyes." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You shall no longer be old.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain and said after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. In the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Give us ears to hear, give us minds to understand, and give us hearts to receive from you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. So I was in the High Street the other day, and I bumped into someone, socially distanced bumping, of course, and I had a chat with her, and then I went home and I said to Paul, oh, you never guess who I met in the High Street. It was, he didn't know who I was talking about. I said, you know, that person we met when we were out walking a few weeks ago, she had a dog. He said, well, everyone in Redbourne has a dog, so he was none the wiser. I said, she's a Teddy Tot's mum, and she's got two older children at the primary school. No, it's still a blank face. What does she look like, he said. Oh, well, I guess she's in her late 30s, maybe. She's got dark shoulder-length hair. She lives up Library Lane. I can see you all trying to guess whether you know the person I'm thinking of. No, still nothing. She belongs to Run Redbourne, and she was telling us all about how she was training for the marathon. Oh, yes, I know who you mean now, he said. I wonder how you would describe somebody to someone else. Or how would you describe yourself? You remember those heady, halcyon days of parties when you might meet someone and you introduce yourself and they ask about yourself and you have to say something? So I wonder how you would describe yourself. Without appearing morbid, whenever I'm at a funeral and you know they give these eulogies, I can't help thinking, I wonder how people would describe me. Well, often we describe ourselves in terms of what we belong to. We might belong to the guides or the scouts. We might belong to the cricket club or the rugby club or the netball group or some other sports club. We might belong to a book group or a drama group. We might belong to a choir. Maybe we belong to the U3A, to some one of those groups, or the MU or the WI. Maybe we might belong to a gym or some other exercise class. I guess quite a lot of us might describe ourselves as belonging to St. Mary's. I wonder what things you belong to. But of course, we can't belong to things quite in the way we want at the moment, or the way that we used to. It's not quite the same belonging online, is it? But we all have a need to belong, to share a common interest, a common purpose. And belonging means that we feel accepted. As Will said, we are celebrating All Saints. And while we do remember those who have died and gone before, All Saints is also a time to remember the living saints. We are the saints of God. We are God's family. And we need to remember and to know that we belong to God. That deep down, that is our identity, whatever else we may belong to. First and foremost, we belong to God, and there is nothing that can take that away from us. Now, I've got a picture I want to show you. I wonder if you can see what that's a picture of. You'll have to shout out a bit louder because you've all got masks on, so we can't hear.
It's a bee.
It's a bee. I hope you can see that. I can't come up to you. I'm not allowed to sort of come walking around the church with it. But it's a picture of a bee on a flower. And if you're watching this online, this will appear very big on the screen, so you'll be able to see it. It's a picture of a bee. And this particular picture was taken by Stephen Boffey, who has taken a lot of the photographs and images that we've been using in our online services. It's a beautiful bee. Now, I'm going to take a risk here because I'm going to suggest that you take your phones out. So if you've got a phone with you, I'm going to suggest you take your phone out. And I'm taking a risk because this is the point at which I might lose you as you realise that you've got emails and text messages that you haven't read yet. So if you can take your phone out and if you take the notice sheet that you were given as you come in, if you look at the top on the left-hand corner, there is a QR code. So if you know how to do this sort of thing, and I hope you do, because I hope you've been scanning as you've come into church, scan your QR code and you should have a picture of that bee that's coming up on your phone so that you can see it close up. And while you're just doing that, I'll just say that back in the summer I actually took part in a webinar that was put on by the Wildlife Trust, and that was a webinar all about bees, and for an hour and a half I think it was, I learned an awful lot about bees, and I think we can remember back to the summer when we probably saw a lot of bees in the garden. So hopefully some of you have been able to do that, have you? Some nods if you can, if it's come up. Oh, fantastic, if it's come up, great. So why am I showing you a picture of a bee? Well, I'm showing you a picture of a bee because I'm talking this morning about this evening and this morning about things that begin with that sound, B. And I hope that having a visual reminder of that B will help you to remember some of the things that we're thinking of today. And the first thing that I want you to remember is that you belong. When you look at that B, to remember that you belong to God, and that is your identity. Now, we had that reading read for us by Darcy from Matthew's Gospel, and a series of sentences all beginning with that blessed, blessed. And because of that, that section of scripture is often referred to as the Beatitudes. And those Beatitudes are actually a list of characteristics of belonging. They are the characteristics of belonging. That word blessed, the Greek word is makarios, and it means a state of being. So it's the nature of what life is like in God's kingdom, how to be attitudes, the belonging attitudes. So very quickly going through them, the poor in spirit, when we know our need of God and our dependence on Him, so much needed at the moment, so much that we need to feel that. Those who mourn, well, we've all lost so much, haven't we? It's that sense of losing anything and also mourning for the sin of the world. Meek is being not aggressive or pushy or controlling. They are the characteristics of belonging to God. And hungering and thirsting after God is that longing for Him, for His heart, for the world and for justice. And the merciful is knowing God's mercy ourselves, how inadequate we are, so that we too can then show mercy. Pure in heart, the desire for God again, and peacemakers, well, that is a measure of the characteristics of belonging to God and the kingdom, to be at peace with each other and with the world. And what does God promise to all of us who belong to Him? He promises us that we will be filled, be comforted. We will receive mercy and see God, belong to God. Just keep looking at your picture on your phone if it's still there. Do save that picture on your phone. I need to be reminded of all those things right now, as we all do. Because, well, I don't know about you, I'm sure you feel the same as me. I am fed up and I am weary. I asked someone the other day how they were feeling, and he said to me, I am downhearted and fatigued. Very poetic, downhearted and fatigued. In other words, fed up and weary. So this reading from Revelation, I think, comes at a very apt time for all of us. Because Revelation is a pastoral letter. And it was written to strengthen and encourage people who at the time lived in what is today modern day Turkey. We've heard of Turkey on the news, haven't we? It was written at a time of deep uncertainty. Does that sound familiar? It was written at a time of earthquakes and plagues. Does that sound familiar? But you know, one of the hallmarks of Revelation is that there is so much praise in it. And we saw some of that in our reading that Matthew read for us. There is so much praise. But almost always, that praise is set in the context of challenging images of suffering. But you know, throughout Scripture, praise transforms our vision of the world, and it transforms us. There is power in praise. Now, we haven't been able to hold our toddler group, our teddy tots, during the lockdown. We haven't been able to start it up again. We thought and we debated, could we do it? And we realized we couldn't do it safely and in a relaxing way. So we thought, what shall we do? And we're so fortunate here at St. Mary's to have a beautiful churchyard and a really large churchyard that we've been using throughout the summer. So we thought, let's carry on using it. So we've been using it for forest tots, and we've been traveling around the churchyard And we've been looking at God's creation and we're stopping at various trees that we've identified as being special trees to engage with God. One of those trees is called a worry tree. There are signs on all the trees, so go around and have a look and see if you can find them. The worry tree, where we've been blowing gigantic bubbles. And we've been thinking about our worries, and the children and the adults have been chasing those bubbles away and stamping on the ones that are persistently still there on the ground. But we always finish at the praising tree. And the praising tree is just behind the garden of ashes and the rose bushes. May I suggest something for you, for all of us? That when you are feeling downhearted and fatigued, fed up and weary, that maybe you could find one of the benches by our praising tree and just sit there for a while. Take out your phone, find that picture of the bee, and just gaze on it for a while. Or if you haven't got that picture, just sit there and try and remember the bees and imagine them buzzing around the rose bushes. And then remember that you belong to God. And if you're watching this online, then find a space inside or outside where you feel comfortable, where you too can sit and think and remember that you belong to God. And then turn to praise. We might not feel much like praising. Sometimes praising is a matter of the will. But turn to praise, be comforted, let God wipe away every tear from your eye, and allow the power of praise to restore you and transform you. Be strengthened. And you might like to take a screenshot of those that passage from Revelation so that you've got some words there on your phone to praise God with. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen. And now allow yourself to be strengthened and be filled as we listen to the song, "As the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs after you."
Thank you. Let's stand and affirm the faith of the Church as we say together the words of the Creed. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We're going to now have our time of prayer. Our prayers of intercession are led for us by Ailsa.
The response to our prayers, Lord, hear us, is Lord, graciously hear us. Across the ages, you, Jesus, have called women and men to follow you and to walk in the way of righteousness and truth. We praise you for the witness of Christians in every generation, for those who have served you, those who taught the gospel to the people, for the ones who struggled for the poor and oppressed, and those who have died a martyr's death. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Give to the world your deep peace, and help us to overcome the oppression and violence that destroys lives. We pray especially for those nations tinged with hatred and injustice, especially at this time in Syria and Yemen. We pray that we find solutions to religious violence across the world. And we pray especially for those families who have lost loved ones in Nice this week. As St. Francis said, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Let us look to a world in where all may have enough. At this present time, we pray for those who will go to bed this evening starving, without food, clean water, and shelters. Wrap your loving arms around them and keep them safe. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious.
We give thanks for all the saints, that they inspire us in our lives. We pray for Bishop Allen and all clergy in the diocese, especially praying for Will and his family, and all those who support and help him. We pray for St. Mary's Redbourne, that it may still provide solace, prayer, and support for all of us during these uncertain times. Though we sometimes feel weary, strengthen us to persevere and so to run the race that lies before us in thankfulness and hope. In Redbourne, we pray for all those that help and support us, whether that be the village shop, the pharmacist, or takeaways. They give support and normality in a time of uncertainty. Lord, we ask that this night you give wisdom to those in authority across the United Kingdom. In the time of uncertainty, give them the knowledge to make decisions which all will support and aid all the peoples of the nations. Guide them to find harmony and solutions in the difficult times ahead. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Comfort and hold all who are sick and sorrowing, and give wisdom and peace to those who need it. We especially think of those on our prayer list at this time, and for everyone who feels sad or lonely. Lord, help us to be always aware of the important things in life, to care for those around us, and to seek your presence in all that we meet. We pray especially for doctors and nurses across the world, and for those scientists who are working hard to find vaccines for coronavirus, but also new drugs for all major illnesses that blight the lives of so many people. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the repose of the souls of Patricia Appleton and Michael Bell. For their families and loved ones, give them your love, your comfort and peace at this time. For those whose years minds fall during this week, give them strength and solace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
In communion with Alban and all the saints, let us commend the world to the mercy and protection of God. Almighty and everlasting God, who enkindles the flame of your love in the hearts of the saints, grant unto us the same faith and power of love, that as we rejoice in their triumphs, we profit by their examples. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Send forth your spirit.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Receive this sign of peace.
Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised.
There is no end of his greatness.
One generation shall praise your works to another.
And shall declare your power.
All your works praise you, Lord.
And your faithful servants bless you.
They make known the glory of your kingdom.
And speak of your power.
My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord.
Let everything bless his holy name forever and ever. May God give you grace to follow his saints in faith and hope and love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.